Hey there, Red Devils fans. We've got some thrilling updates for you. Please subscribe and turn on notification for daily Manchester United news updates. Manchester United's win over Liverpool was so big that even Jadon Sancho was paying attention to it. Jadon Sancho effectively quit on this Manchester United team earlier in the season when he refused to make amends with manager Erik ten Hag. He was sent out on loan to Borussia Dortmund at the first possible opportunity, where his form has begun to pick up over the last couple of matches. Perhaps this has improved his spirits, because Sancho was back on social media showing his support for a Manchester United teammate after the team's FA Cup quarterfinal win. Manchester United's previous win against Liverpool was in August 2022, Erik ten Hag's first competitive victory as manager. Jadon Sancho scored the opening goal in that game, a 2-1 win. This time around, United's victory was even more dramatic. After the score was 2-2 at full time, United won 4-3 in extra time, with a mad netting a 120th minute winner. Jadon Sancho is not the only player to experience a difficult season. In different ways, Marcus Rashford's has been challenging, struggling to replicate his form last season. Rashford missed a late chance to win the game 3-2 against Liverpool in this game, before bouncing back to net a vital equalizer in extra time to tie the game 3-3. Following United's win, Rashford posted a celebratory message on social media, which read, "Nights like this," hailing the unbeatable experience of a Stretford End winner against a rival. Rashford's pal Sancho responded with a two-word message, reading, "World class," lauding Rashford. Whatever Sancho's feelings towards Manchester United, he is clearly happy for Marcus Rashford. This was Rashford's 8th goal in all competitions this season, a long way short of his 30 last season, but he is not giving up, unlike Sancho. Meanwhile, Manchester United saw two young players combine for a dramatic winner in extra time against Liverpool, which will be replayed again and again. Alejandro Garnacho and Amad sprang a classic counter-attacking move on Jurgen Klopp's side, with the Ivory Coast youngster scoring the 120th minute winner. Amad in particular should revel in his big moment. He has had a tough season, and this is the turning point his career needs. But his late winner would not have been possible without the tireless performances of his teammates, led by captain Bruno Fernandes. Erik ten Hag made 5 substitutions, and his final throw of the dice was to bring on Mason Mount for Victor Lindelof. He had 103 touches in total, and contributed defensively with 2 clearances and 4 interceptions, winning 7 duels in total. Fernandes was a key part of this, filling in late in the game where you might normally have expected Casemiro to drop deep instead. Now, he is just 2 wins away from lifting another trophy at Wembley, again and again. Bruno Guimaraes to spark 100 Mimiro's transfer battle with Man United, Man City, Chelsea and Liverpool to launch summer moves. Bruno Guimaraes is set to be at the center of a huge transfer battle this summer, according to reports. The Brazilian, 26, joined Newcastle in January 2022 and has been sensational for the Northeast club. Guimaraes has scored 13 goals and assisted another 13 in 96 appearances for the club, and is now attracting interest from a host of teams. They include Manchester City, who have identified him as their top midfield target ahead of Bayern Munich's Joshua Kimmich and Aston Villa's Douglas Luiz. According to AS, the Premier League champions have already contacted the player's representatives as they look to trigger his 100 million release clause. Manager Pep Guardiola previously spoke glowingly about Guimaraes, who is under contract with Newcastle until 2028 after signing an extension earlier this season. He said, "Exceptional holding midfielder, aggressive. With the ball, he has pause. In set pieces, he is aggressive." Now Newcastle wants to grow, and I am quite sure that it is part of their project for the next few years. Definitely. However, Man City face plenty of competition in their pursuit of the South American, who has 18 caps for Brazil. Liverpool and Chelsea both showed interest in the midfielder in the past and are set to renew their inquiries. Manchester United are also expected to come in for the Newcastle star, particularly if Dan Ashworth completes his switch to become sporting director at Old Trafford. And there are also clubs outside of the Premier League understood to be monitoring Guimaraes. Paris Saint-Germain could return with another attempt to sign him, having previously failed to do so due to a financial fair play issue. But Guimaraes' dream move is believed to be Barcelona, with club president Joan Laporta and sporting director Deco Keane on the transfer. However, the Catalan Giants will only be able to afford an offer in the region of 68 milers. They will also have to sell several players before they sign Guimaraes due to their desperate financial situation. Again, please subscribe and turn on notification for daily Manchester United news updates. Liverpool boss Jurgen Klopp appears to be an admirer of Manchester United midfielder Kobbie Mainoo. The youngster delivered yet another impressive performance at Old Trafford with two moments, highlighting his quality. In the first half, which was mostly dominated by United, Mainoo went on a mazy run through the Liverpool team, which saw him glide beyond Joe Gomez and Wataru Endo with ease. Scott McTominay had given the hosts the lead, but they were behind with just a few minutes remaining of the first period, with Alexis Mac Allister and Mohamed Salah on target. With many inside Old Trafford likely in awe of the midfielder, Klopp also appeared to be feeling similar emotions as he stuck out his hand to give Mainoo a high five as he left the field. Despite the Academy graduate clearly being a Ten Hag favorite, the Manchester United boss has carefully managed his minutes and also not put lofty expectations on his shoulders. Again and again. Manchester United are interested in signing Antonio Silva from Benfica this summer, according to reports. The Reds will be dipping into the transfer market for defensive reinforcements at the end of the season. Not only has our defensive department been hit with injury crisis after injury crisis throughout the season, it is clear that a number of our defenders are aging players, and that needs to be addressed sooner rather than later. That means our scouts will be kept busy at the task of identifying the right players for United. Hitz understands that United had scouts in Portugal watching Benfica at the weekend. The report states that the main reason for United's visit was to continue their checks on highly rated central defender Antonio Silva. Silva, 20, plays on the right side of defense, which means he could be a potential partner for Lisandro Martinez. Granted, the Argentine can avoid any more long-term injuries. He has scored 2 goals in 21 appearances for Benfica this season, and I think we'll hear his name more often in the coming months. Benfica, who are currently on top of Liga Portugal, recorded a 4-0 win over Portimonense, and former United winger Angel Di Maria got his name on the score sheet. United scouts also got a chance to keep an eye on João Neves, who is another young player at Benfica, attracting lots of attention from top European clubs. Subscribe to the Stretti News podcast, StrettiCast, for weekly episodes on Manchester United. You can also sign up to the ad-free Stretti newsletter. Get the Stretti News verdict on all matters Manchester United. Meanwhile, Real Madrid could re-sign Rafael Varane and Casemiro in the summer, according to reports. Spanish website Fichajes claims that Los Blancos are closely monitoring their situation at Man Ut. President Florentino Perez and Real Madrid boss Carlo Ancelotti have begun an exhaustive analysis of the situation.